Good morning and welcome in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. It's the 8th of November and today will be our Act of Remembrance service today together. Very different from other years where normally the town would gather together to mark this important occasion. But today as we take part in our Act of Remembrance, you are encouraged, as we did with the NHS, to go in those 2 minutes silence and stand on your doorstep to mark this occasion as we unite together in remembering those who have gone before us. But that'll be a little bit later on in our service. Let me just bring you up to speed. How have you got on this week? Have you seen anybody? Have you been in touch with anyone? Have you spoke to anyone? And if the answer to any of those is no, then please get in touch with our pastoral care team. Who'll give you a call and they'll have a little chat with you and just make contact. No one must be left alone in these difficult times. Today we take precious time to remember those who have been lost in war and conflict, and to also remember the sacrifice of our Lord Jesus. But as always, a little bit of an update. The hall, we have the keys. We finally have the keys to our new home. And this means that all those things that we talked about a few weeks ago, about coming and looking round the hall and having our day of prayer and thanksgiving and filming our final service from High Street and our new service from the new hall, can all take place. And the dates for all of that and how you can get involved are listed in your written resource. So do get involved if you are able. These are exciting and challenging times, aren't they? But I would ask for your prayers for the safety and protection and travelling mercies for all who are concerned with that transition and move from one building to another. Our prayer focus this week, the churches together in Scotland have asked us to unite in prayer with the following, or the prayer that's written into your written resource. And perhaps you could use this as part of your 8 o'clock on a Sunday evening prayer for our core and our fellowship and also the wider church. It's there to use if you are able to make use of that. Just bear with me, let's see what else I needed to mention to you. Yes, God's word for our core. Our pastoral team would like us to choose a verse of scripture for us to meditate on and lean on in these days of change. A verse that will bring blessing to both the building, the people of our fellowship and the community. In your written resource, we've specially chosen readings, and we would love to hear from you which one you think we should adopt as a core for the weeks and months ahead. Whenever your pastoral support person contacts you, perhaps you could let them know which of the readings speaks to you the most and you think we should use in these days ahead of us, and certainly before the 20th of November when we have our next Pastoral Care Council meeting. Those are listed in your written resource. Have a read on them, pray about them, meditate on them, and come back to us with which you think we should use. Before we move off into the rest of our worship, let's pause for a moment and pray. Father God, we today take time to remember. We remember those who've gone before us. We remember those who are dealing with conflict now. And we remember, Lord, that you yourself gave your Son as an offering for our sins. Help us to accept and understand that in these difficult days. Help us to lean upon it when we are struggling and in conflict ourselves. And help us, Lord, to remember and be reminded today that you loved us so much that you gave us your Son. Father, bless us in this time of worship, and in return may our offering of worship be a blessing to you, in and through your precious Son's name. Amen. So our opening song this morning is a prayer of thanks for all those saints who've gone before us. We take time this morning to remember. Join us as we sing together, and this will be followed by our act of remembrance. And as I said, after the Lone Piper's Lament has played, if you want to observe that 2-minute silence on your doorstep, please do so. If that's not convenient or possible for you, then you are welcome to join on the screen with the act of remembrance by the Royal British Legion in the form of a video.
Please stand. Teach us, good Lord, to serve thee as thou deservest, to give and not to count the cost, to fight and not to heed the wounds, to toil and not to seek for rest, to labor and not to ask for any reward, save that of knowing we do thy will. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
They shall grow not old, as we that are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. at the going down of the sun and in the morning. We will remember them.
Thank you.
When you go home, tell them of us and say, for your tomorrow, we gave our today.
Who heard the call and bore for us.
take a moment to think about all the things we are asked to remember. Feed the dog, put the bins out, pick up a newspaper, pay the bills, phone a friend or a family member. And they're just the day-to-day mundane things. Then there's the traditions of, what about remember the 5th of November, gunpowder, treason and plot. The Christmas and birthday card list, remembering to send them off or hand them out. Opening the advent calendar as we approach that time of year. And of course, Remembrance Day, which we mark today. And then there's the spiritual disciplines, remembering to pay our tithe, to be still, remembering to daily.
If you'd like to turn to your
Bible,
scriptures, they will be on the screen, but if you
pray
your own Bibles,
about all
then
things.
Turn with me, please, to Luke.
Today's
chapter
a day that means many things to different people.
Whether you are young, old, actively involved in the armed
then
services,
came the day of unleavened
or
bread,
just know someone
the
who is
lamb
or has
to be
been
sacrificed.
Remembrance
Jesus
Day
sent
and
Peter and
John
Sunday
saying,
service
go and make preparations for us to eat
leading
the
up
Passover.
To it, an important date.
Where do you want
in
us
our
to
national
prepare for it?
And our Christian calendar.
He replied, as you
link
enter
to
the city,
a whole
a
man
range
jar
of
emotions
will meet you
and memories.
Follow
held
him
by
to the
people,
house that he enters.
They can
and
be
say to the owner
painful
of the
days.
House, the teacher,
but
asks,
they can also be
where
days
is the
to
guest
remember
room,
our goal,
where I may eat
and
the
God's
Passover
goal
with my disciples
of peace.
He will show you a large room upstairs, all furnished.
Today,
make
let us take a moment
there
to consider what
they left
we are being
things
asked
to remember,
just as Jesus had
why
told them,
and
so
how
they
it affects
the
people,
and how the occasion
when
can
the
and should
came, Jesus
be
and his apostles
marked
reclined at the table.
But at
and
the same
time,
them,
I have eagerly desired to eat this Passover
such an
with
important
you before I suffer.
I
for
want
I
us
tell
to
you,
spend
I will
time
not eat
in the Lord's presence
until it finds
with
fulfillment
his
in the
word,
kingdom of God.
Looking at the whole
after
concept
taking the cup, he gave
of remembering,
and said,
and
take
considering
this
the
and
fact that
divide
our Father
it among you, for I tell you, I will not drink again from
in
the
our
fruit
faith
of the vine
and
until
discipleship
the kingdom
walk
of God comes.
And that he wants us,
and he took bread,
to forget,
gave thanks, and broke
things,
and gave it to them,
and
saying,
not
this
remember
is my
them
body, given for you.
Let's start at
do
Genesis
in
chapter 9.
Of me.
Very famous story of Noah and the flood. One of the earliest things God wants us to remember and understand is his first covenant with his people. I will remember my covenant between me and you and all living creatures of every kind. Never again will the waters become a flood to destroy all life. Whenever the rainbow appears in the clouds, I will see it and remember the everlasting covenant between God and all living creatures of every kind on earth. So God said to Noah, remember, this is the sign of the covenant I have established between me and all life on earth. You know, the story of Noah and the flood is, of course, a story about the promise God makes with his people to show his steadfast love. What do you think when you see a rainbow? To me, it reminds me of God's greatness, God's mercy, God's love, and God's ability to make even the worst situations into something amazing and beautiful. God says, remember, this is a sign of the covenant I have established between me and all life on earth. The Saviour, Creator, Sovereign God asking us to remember him and his covenant promises. Secondly, Exodus chapter 20, familiar words, I am sure, the Ten Commandments. All to be remembered and all to be kept. Remember the Lord your God. Remember the name of the Lord is holy and to be kept this way. Remember the Sabbath and to keep this day special, to worship him alone. The Ten Commandments are a gift from God to help us live in peace and harmony. I often wonder, on Remembrance Day in particular, if everyone in the world would be willing to accept, adopt and abide by these 10 God-honouring rules.
would there be a place for war anymore? Thirdly, moving into the New Testament, Jesus had much to say on remembering. In Matthew chapter 6, verses 8 to 13, he taught us to remember the Lord's Prayer and to use it as a model for praying. In one of my schools, the children were challenged to learn and recite the Lord's Prayer from memory, which was a good discipline. But of course, it's not enough to know the Lord's Prayer. The challenge is to know its author. Close your eyes for a moment and listen to the familiar words of the family prayer, but with a little time to reflect after each section and to ponder anew what it means for you and what Jesus wants his followers to remember. Perhaps you can take time this week to remember and think about each of the parts of that prayer the Lord told us to remember and pray. Fourthly, Luke chapter 22, again familiar words, especially around Easter time. Let me remind you of one of the most intimate scenes between Jesus and his closest friends. From our scripture reading earlier. When the hour came, Jesus and his apostles reclined at the table, and he said to them, "I have eagerly desired to eat this Passover meal with you before I suffer. For I tell you, I will not eat it again until it finds fulfillment in the kingdom of God." After taking the cup, he gave thanks and said, "Take this and divide it among you. For I tell you, I will not drink again from the fruit of the vine until the kingdom of God." And he took bread, gave thanks, and broke it, and gave it to them, saying, "This is my body, given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." I don't know if you've experienced one of those beautiful love feasts, perhaps on a Maundy Thursday who or around the Holy Week time.
Hallowed
but that time when
be
we just
thy name.
Take time to remember our Lord's final hours as a human on earth, sharing
thy
could be doing so many
come,
other things
and
thy will be done
preparing
on
himself
earth
to be crucified,
as it is in heaven.
But instead, sharing and telling his disciples to remember him and his sacrifice.
Today we remember
this
thousands
day, our
and thousands of soldiers, airmen
and
women and sailors who have given their lives in
debtors.
Sacrifice to protect and secure our freedom, not only in past times and wars gone by, but also in recent times, Iraq and Afghanistan,
to
and
name
lead us
but
not
a few.
Into temptation.
But
Jesus
us
challenges
from
us
evil.
To remember daily his body, his whipped, beaten, scoffed at, pierced, torn, nailed to a cross, For thine is the kingdom,
buried,
the power,
and for
the
each
glory,
one of us,
forever
as the ultimate
and ever.
Sacrifice.
Amen.
For true freedom of our souls, so that we might live in eternal life with him. Today gives us a chance to remember those who have died in the name of freedom and justice. And we must remember especially the bringer of true freedom and justice, Jesus Christ, our Saviour. I'd invite you to sing along with these words, Jesus Christ, I think upon your sacrifice. You became nothing, poured out to death. Many times I've wondered at your gift of life, and I'm in that place once again. And once again, I look upon the cross where you died. I'm humbled by your mercy, and I'm broken inside. Once again, I thank you. Once again, I pour out my life. Let's sing together.
Sacrifice, you became nothing, poured out to death. Many times I've wondered at your gift of life, and I'm in that place once again. And I'm in that place once again. And once again I look up where you died. I'm humbled by your mercy and I'm broken inside. Once again I thank you, once again I pour out my life. Now you exalted to the highest place, King of the heavens, where one day I'll bow. But for now, I marvel at this saving grace, and I'm full of praise once again. And I'm full of praise once again. And once again.
So these are just a few of the things we are charged with remembering in our daily strive to become more like Jesus. And the list goes on. The book of Hebrews tells us to remember to do good and remember to show hospitality. Peter instructs us to remember to be holy as God is holy. We must remember to love our neighbours. And as Matthew records, we must remember Jesus said, go and make disciples. However, God's word makes it clear that there should be things we should not remember and should try to forget instead. Philippians chapter 3, verses 12 to 14 says, not that I have already obtained all this or have already arrived at my goal, but I press on to take hold of that for which Christ Jesus took hold of me. Brothers and sisters, I do not consider myself yet to have taken hold of it. But one thing I do, forgetting what is behind and straining forward to what is ahead, I press on to the goal to win the prize for which God has called me heavenward in Christ Jesus. Forgetting what is behind and straining forward. You know, the media will paint the worst picture. People will try to shackle you in daily life. The devil, as the father of all lies, will try to stop you will stop you reaching your full potential. You know, that's a whole sermon in itself. But as we fill our minds with the things God wants us to remember, remember this: forget what has passed. That doesn't mean forget all your precious memories of childhood or family or the ones that you love, but forget the hurts, forget the disappointments, forget the human failings, forget the setbacks, the discouragements you may have felt, perhaps even from people within the fellowship. Don't dwell on them or try to drag people back to them. Instead, as Paul says, press forward, stride out in the direction Jesus would take you, and be a channel of peace and reconciliation. Believe in yourself and the Holy Spirit within you. Believe in what he can accomplish through Christ. Aim for the prize of a place with him in heaven by keeping in tune with him. Which brings us back to that spiritual disciplines that we mentioned at the start of today. So let me conclude by saying, today as we remember the lost, the fallen and the sacrifices, remember the covenant love of our Father. Remember the commands and guidance from him. Remember the need for the daily discipline of tithing, reading the Bible and praying. And remember the ultimate sacrifice of Christ on the cross. And remember, we need to forget the things that would harm us, suppress us, or count against us. Instead, hand them over to our Father God and press on to the prize of knowing Jesus. I'd encourage you to reflect on those words as we listen to the lovely music, "Make Me a Channel of Your Peace."
Peace, where there is this hatred, let me bring your love. Where there is injury, your pardon, Lord. And where there's doubt, true faith in you. Make me a channel of your peace. Where there's despair in life, let me bring hope. Where there is darkness, only light. And where there's sadness, ever joy. Must have grown that I may never seek so much to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love.
Our closing song starts with the words, "The day thou gavest, Lord, is ended, the darkness falls as they behest. To thee our morning hymn has ascended, thy praise shall sanctify our rest." I pray this morning that the peace of God will rest upon you, especially if you've ever been affected by the effects of war and conflict. We'll share this song together, and then I'll share our closing benediction. Let us say this prayer together, these words before our Father God. Let's pray. Thank you for your calming peace, Lord, in the midst of what often are troubled seas. Go before me today, I pray. Grant me help in forgetting all that would harm me, and show me anew all that you would want me to do, remember, to think, and say, and do. In the name of Jesus, whose sacrifice I remember today. Now our benediction this morning is taken from Philippians chapter 4, verse 8. Finally, brothers and sisters, whatever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable, if anything is excellent or praiseworthy, think about, remember such things. Good morning and God bless.